don't want to throw those things away. We've got to keep those because those are the very things that's going to enable you or endorse you to take part in the reign. You have to obey these scriptures. So when people talk against Christianity, I understand where they're coming from, but I also understand that there are some intricate parts of it that they are missing, that they are not getting. And it comes through the apostles' doctrine. When Christ came, who did he chose? He chose 12 apostles, and he imparted in them all of the things that they were to preach and to teach. He lived with them. They dwell with him. They sat with him. They ate with him. They watched him perform miracles. And he taught them the plan of salvation. Then when he got ready to leave and step on the cloud, he gave them the final ultimatum. He gave them the commission, told them to go ye into all the world and preach the gospel and to every Christian. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. You don't hear that too much in the Hebrew community because it's by design. The enemy don't want you to have that part. But that's an intricate part of your salvation that you cannot refuse. Now, they jump over all of that, and they go right back into the shadows of the law, statutes, and commandments, which are good. But they were written for us to be a school, as a schoolmaster, for us to know the difference in wrong and right. It's almost like saying that if a person got a picture, like a picture of me, and they're pointing at the picture, but then I come in the room and they say, oh, there he is, but you want to keep on looking at the picture, and you got the person standing right in front of you. Some of you all making relate to what I'm saying. But a lot of people are still pointing at the picture. They're still looking at what is to come that has already came and given us everything that we need. All right, that was a portion of my introduction. Now we're going to go into the Word of God. Come on, give God some praise. Hallelujah. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquity, and the chastisement of our peace was on him, and by his stripes we are healed. All of that was pointing to who? Pointing to Christ. Come on, give God praise. All right. This is Father's Day. And I know you all have heard the statement, what is a woman? That they going, you know, they got this thing going, what is a woman? You mean to tell me after all this time, you don't know what a woman is? The enemy have come in and stolen the concept from you of what a woman is. A woman had the capability of being a mother. A woman was drawn from the rib of Adam and created to be his helpmeet. Come on, give God praise. But the world have designed confusion and caused everybody to become confused. You can't even answer a question of what a woman is. Look at your mother. That's a woman. It took a woman to usher in, bring life into the world. A woman is a powerful individual. She got power to overturn her household. Remember Eve when she disobeyed and went and ate the fruit of the tree and then gave it to her husband? Now her husband should have had some of that bone in his back to tell his woman, hey, look, no, wasn't we commanded not to eat it or even touch it? Put that down. And I believe that it could have been reinstated. God would have covered that because the man had the fortitude to straighten out the woman. Because every time the man have to stand up in the household every now and then. Where y'all at? Now, I ain't telling you to be like, what's that movie? The Color Purple. You know, the color purple, he got the woman just doing everything, and he going down to see Suge Avery. Come on, give God praise. And Suge Avery wasn't nothing but old drunk in the nightclub doing her thing. But you fixing up the house for Suge Avery. And you got the best thing that ever happened to you right there before you. Come on, give God praise. Suge Avery didn't give a hoot about him. She got somebody that turned against him because of the treatment that she got from him. Turned against him. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah. So now, men, we have a powerful responsibility. We got to stand in the position, and we got to be able to raise our families. Do you hear me? It's hard to find a responsible man. You have to come to the house of the Lord. I thank him for blessing me to raise my family. I was a young man when I came in here. I never want to forget my testimony. I want to share it with people because sometimes people don't seem to feel as though it's important for you to be a young man when you come in here. Young men need to have a change in their life. They need to pull away from a lot of this stuff that's out here that's causing us to be hooked on drugs, causing us to put our women on the street, causing us to be murderers of our own people. We got to be pulled out of that type of activity. We got to be responsible to our households, responsible to our families. We got to be the individual that our children can look up to and be proud of. Come on, give God praise. We don't need to be the pauper of a rolling stone. Everywhere that you lay your hat is your home. And then when you die, all you leaving them, you ain't leaving them no inheritance, no property, no money. All you leave them is a loan. Well, the Bible says a good man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. That's his grandchildren. He got so much going for him that it's going to override his immediate children and trickle on down to his grandchildren. Don't you want that? Yes. And you're not going to live a life that you're deprived on the way to it. You're going to be blessed as you live your life and have so much overflowing that it's going to flow down to your family. Come on, give them praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I'm so glad that I got this before I was awakened. That's the problem. A lot of people wake up before they get the transitional formation of what being saved is and having the blood applied to your life. So you end up being a zealot. You become overzealous about being awakened, that you fight everything, you fight everybody because they're not doing it the way that you do it. But when you're mature, you're able to make concessions for people and talk to people until they get to that place to make a transition. If they expected me, many a time that I heard the gospel, to change the first time that I heard it, I wouldn't have had a chance. But somebody kept on telling it to me, and I kept on watching it. And listen, when I was watching it, I seen some things that weren't quite right. People have a problem with that. When they looking and they see somebody, oh, he ain't right, oh, she ain't right, so I ain't getting in, ain't none of them right. So you're going to go to hell because people are not perfect? You're going to make some mistakes along the way. Where y'all at? Hallelujah. I feel hot in here. What's going on? Amen. So if you're hot now, it's a place hotter than this. If you can't stand this, you definitely can't stand that. It's a place that's one way in, no way out. Come on, give God praise. All right. Let me go and just give you a few scriptures. In the Bible, it talks about Adam. We talking about men today, fathers. Adam was the father of all humanity. He was the first man that was created, according to our Bible. And he was given a whole lot of wisdom. If you really check the information, Adam was a very, very intelligent individual. He was so smart that he could name every last one of the animals that you see. And when you see it, it looked like the name of it. An elephant looks like an elephant. A gorilla looked like a gorilla. Where y'all at? A monkey looked like a monkey. So he named each of these creatures, and the name fits to a T. So God had given him some insurmountable wisdom to sit down, and God brought the animal before him. He named the animal. What you gonna call this Adam? Oh, that's an armadillo. What you gonna call this Adam? That's an alligator. He named all of them. So God gave him some wisdom that the people in the world are using that wisdom that God gave them. You don't see, man, you got something on the inside of you. The Bible talks about faith. You know that faith, all things are possible to them that believe. So if you believe a thing, you can bring it to pass. You can work it through faith. And sometimes you can work faith against your own destiny. You got some people that had faith that they wanted to be rich and got rich. And guess what? The riches choked all the life out of them. So you got to direct that energy toward the right source. Faith without God, you can have faith in evil. Because you got some people that are running the world right now, got faith in what they're doing. They believe what they're going to do. But God's going to come in at the end and crush everything that they're doing. But look at what they have done. Look at what they have accomplished through that ignorant faith that they have in what they're doing. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Come on, give God praise. So we got a lot of things now that are happening in our world today. And a lot of people don't understand what's happening. A lot of people are going to be lost because they don't want to humble themselves and hear what thus said the Lord. A lot of people are going to be washed away in all of this false knowledge and false wisdom that is going forward. But those of us that name the name of Christ, those of us that can stand on the foundation, those of us that believe in this truth. It's a truth in what we're believing in. I believe today is Juneteenth, right? Yes. Hey, don't they celebrate Juneteenth? You all know what that is? That's a day commemorating how that we were supposed to be set free. A lot of people accomplished a lot through the being set free, but some stayed on the plantation. And this is a holiday, I believe, June the 19th, Juneteenth. They call it Juneteenth. That's a day for us, but do you know the other people celebrate it too? What part of it are they celebrating? Do you think they celebrate our liberty? They're celebrating trying to keep us down. Where y'all at? They don't want to see what is happening right before our eyes. So let me say this as I get ready to go to my seat, because I know a lot of you all got some plans for today and to celebrate with your fathers. And just speaking on that, my father left in 1999. And I haven't seen him since, because he passed away in that year. So those of you that have a father present, you ought to give praise to the Lord for your father. Come on, give God a hand praise. Let me see the hands of the fathers. Anybody in it? Let me see the hands of those that got children. Oh, okay. That's a blessing. That's a blessing. That's a blessing. Now, Adam was in a position to where when he sinned, it came down to all of us. So a second Adam had to come, which was Christ, that came and brought a plan of salvation to us. And what disturbs me the most is that people that are awakened, they have a tendency, they have been indoctrinated not to believe in the salvation plan. They don't think that it's of God. They don't think the Most High initiated this. They have twisted it because it was by design that Constantine got in there and twisted things up to push you away from it so that you wouldn't have that part. So what are you going to have when the Most High comes, when he looks to identify with his spirit that he put in you? If you don't have it, he said, if any man have not the spirit of Christ, he's what? He's none of his. So if you don't have the spirit of Christ, he can't deal with you. You're still functioning in carnality. Come on, somebody. I must be in the wrong church today. Y'all give me about 5 minutes because I see them fans swinging back and forth. Y'all must be hot. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But at Antioch, they were called Christians, getting back to the Christian part. Now, I'm not telling you to, you know, go out and try to recruit anybody because there's a stigma that the world have accumulated against Christians. The word Christian has become too religious for people. And they don't like you to say, I'm talking about folk that's supposed to be awakened. When you say Christian, it stifles them. They can't deal with the word Christian anymore. But it's a trick to that. So you don't have to call it Christian. You don't have to call it being Christian. Because the Bible said that Antioch, they first called them Christians before Constantine came in and contaminated. So that was a time that the church was being persecuted for being a Christian. Put to death. You read in the book of Hebrews, it talks about a lot of things that the people of God went through. They were sawn asunder. Some of them were beat just for calling on a certain name. They were killed, they were halt, they were maimed. And a lot of the old medieval instruments that you see of torture, they don't tell you, but a lot of those medieval torture instruments was for Christians, that they tortured us. So all of that led up to Constantine coming in and say, we're going to have to put a stop to this. We could use this. We can catapult this and make it a governmental system. Now, what we're going to have here coming up pretty soon, they're going to try to implement this social scheme. They want to make it a social scheme for everybody. You're going to have a social credit score to where you're going to be able to have certain rights because you was a good girl or a good boy. Come on, somebody. They're monitoring everything you do. Every site that you've been on, they know the site. So they put something up there that you like. If you've been shopping, you get on your computer, the next thing you know, the very thing you were looking at, bam, there it is. They're monitoring you, every move you make. You got fingerprints. If you've been on the nasty sites, they'll put some nasty stuff on there. Come on, give God praise. Y'all don't want to talk to me. Wherever you've been, they tracking you. They want to be like God. They want to be the all-seeing eye. They want to know, they want to have the omniscience, meaning knowing everything. They want to be omnipresent. They want to be everywhere you being monitored. Now they got face recognition. Have you ever seen on the videos where they got a little thing that show who the face is, then the name come up there? That's the devil trying to mimic who God is and his intelligence to be able to funnel us all the way into a channel to where we'll be controlled. I wish I had some help up in here. And what we're doing now has everything to do with that. The church, well, the people don't like church anymore. Let me see what word I can use besides church. The called out ones, the awakened people. It has everything to do with us. This place where we come and we should be learning about these things. If they're perpetrating evil against you, how you gonna know if you don't know? Somebody gotta tell you. You remember the Ethiopian eunuch that was out there reading the Bible? In the book of Acts, the 8th chapter. I'm gonna get that and I'm gonna get ready to close on that. I'm gonna get this mic, Sister Coleman. Go to Acts 8, I believe it might be 36. I'm going to read this to you. We're going to look into a few scriptures because you ain't going to get this in the Hebrew community. You got to come to Bishop Coleman to get this kind of stuff. Come on, give God praise. Let us start about verse number. Let's go to verse number 30. Acts 8 and 30. Y'all listen to this.
Moreover, whom he did predestinate.
No, Acts 8 and 30. Hallelujah. Okay. Amen. You ain't got your glasses today.
And Philip ran thither to him.
So see, he needs a man that's going to run and do the work. The Bible says, go run you into the streets of Jerusalem and see if you can find me a man that will execute judgment. All right, come on, read.
And Philip ran thither to him.
Philip ran up to him.
And heard him read the prophet Esaias.
Uh-huh.
And said, understandest thou readest.
Okay, now hold on. I want you to know who he ran to. Go to verse 27 and read that. So you can get some clarity.
And he arose and went.
So the Lord got Philip and made him get up out of the midst of a revival and spoke to him and told him what?
And behold, a man of Ethiopia.
A man of who?
Ethiopia.
Now they told us that, you know, the man, the Simon the Cyrenian that helped Christ carry the cross, they wanted to highlight, oh, we got a black man in the Bible. He helped Christ carried the cross. But here we find an Ethiopian eunuch. This what? Read.
A eunuch of great authority.
Great authority. Come on.
And the Candace, queen of Ethiopia.
The queen of the Ethiopians.
Who had the charge of all her treasure.
Had charge of all the money. He was no broke brother.
And come to Jerusalem for to worship.
And he was coming to where?
Jerusalem.
So the people were coming from all over. So don't let people tell you that, oh, it was a black man that they carried the cross. No, they were coming from all over. Coming to Jerusalem to worship. How you going to worship something you don't know about? So you know to come there. So you got connection with it. Come on, somebody. And read.
Was returning and sitting in his chariot.
Oh, he got a chariot?
Read
he got
his
a ride? You mean to tell me he got a limousine? Yeah. Come on, read.
Read Esaias the prophet.
And he know how to read? Yeah. This back in the Bible day.
Yeah.
This black Ethiopian man know how to read. In charge of all the treasure. And coming to Jerusalem for the Pentecost. Come on, read.
Then the Spirit said unto Philip,
what did he say?
Go near and join thyself to this chariot.
And Philip was a brother too, by the way. Go join yourself to the chariot.
And Philip ran thither to him.
So he ran up there to him.
And heard him read the prophet Esaias.
And he heard him reading. No wonder they don't want you to know how to read. Burning up all the books and taking the books and We're going to put you to death when we find you reading. You better not have told that to the Ethiopian eunuch.
Right.
Come on, give God praise. Because he was reading. Come on, read.
And said.
What did he say?
Understandest thou what thou readest?
A lot of people don't understand what they're reading. They don't understand it. They got the wrong teacher trying to teach them. If you're not saying what they want to hear, they'll get up and walk out. Because it's not familiar. But here's a man reading, but he just was honest. I don't understand this. Come on, read.
And he said.
What did he say?
How can I?
How can I understand this?
Except some man should guide me.
So somebody had some sense way back then. Somebody got to open up my understanding of what I'm reading. You crack up in the Bible sometime, you need some help with that Bible. Or else you'll be calling it a white man's book.
Yeah.
Come on, give God praise. Ain't nowhere in the world no man going to write a book that's going to condemn him. Gonna write a book that's gonna put him in hell. Amen. This ain't no white man's book. This book belongs to us. Amen. I ain't got nothing against no white man. So YouTube, y'all just scratch that off. I got white friends. Come on, give God praise. But I'm just talking about our Bible right now. Come on, read.
And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him.
So he said, come on, man, I need you to help me to point this stuff out to me. What is this talking about? Come on, read.
The place of the scripture which he read was this. He was led as a sheep to the slaughter.
Hallelujah. Come on, read.
And like a lamb dumb before his shearer,
uh-huh.
So openeth he not his mouth.
So it's talking about somebody. But the Ethiopian eunuch said, who is this talking about? Come on, read.
In his humiliation, his judgment was taken away.
Right, read.
And who shall declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth.
Read.
And the eunuch answered Philip.
What did he answer?
And said, I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this, of himself or of some other man?
So this is, he was honest. Say, look, I pray thee. It means, man, I need some help with this. Who is he talking about? Is he talking about himself or who? Or another prophet?
Or a prophet?
Uh-huh.
Of himself?
Uh-huh.
Or some other man?
Read.
Then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture and preached unto him Jesus.
Oh, so he started right there and started preaching Jesus. Or Yahushua. You know, because I got to break it down. Because some people hear Jesus. Oh, he said Jesus. Come on, let's go. He preached Yahushua. Or Yahawashah.
Yeah.
Come on. So you're going to fault me because I say Yahawashah. You need to say Yahushua. No, you need to say Yeshua. So when we going to fight over that? Do we know who he talking about? Come on, give God praise, somebody. But people will make a doctrine out of that. You got to call him this. You can't call him that, I'm out. You missing it, my friend. You got to be more broad-minded than that. It's been time that Peter, or Paul rather, was teaching. And then all of a sudden he'll detour and stop talking in Aramaic and slide over and start talking in Hebrew because he knew he had a better audience that understood Hebrew.
Yeah.
So you're going to let dialect separate you from salvation? Come on now. Come on, read.
And as they went on their way, they came unto a certain water.
Hold it. It must be somewhere in that conversation that water came up. Because the Bible said at first he didn't understand. But all of a sudden, some water, hold on. They came to a certain water, read.
And the eunuch said.
And the eunuch said, hold on, I thought he didn't know what he was reading. So somebody had to explain to him about some water. Come on, read.
See, here is water.
This is the eunuch talk. See, here is water.
What doth hinder me to be baptized?
Why come people ain't talking about that now? What doth hinder me to being baptized? The eunuch, he know he need to be baptized because the man of God sat up on the chariot and explained it to him. That's what these brothers need to be doing. We need to be able to rescue one another and open up our minds to more than arguing and fussing and fighting about a dialect, about where you didn't say this or you didn't say that. You need to get clean first. You need to get a mess out of you first. You need to get sin out of you first. Then you'll be able to see clearly where you're going. Come on, read.
And Philip said, if thou believest with all thine heart.
If you believe with all your heart, if you repent deep enough.
Thou mayest.
Uh-huh.
And he answered and said.
What did he say?
I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
I believe that Yahushua is the Son of God.
And he commanded the chariot.
Uh-huh.
To stand still.
Said, whoa. Stop. And then what happened?
And they went down both in the water.
Both of them went in there?
Both.
Both of them, because if we don't do that sprinkling thing like the Catholics do. If you're going to be buried, you need somebody going to have to take you down. Kedusha. Come on, give God some praise.
Hallelujah.
You got to be buried. They both went down into water.
Both Philip.
And the eunuch.
And he baptized him.
Holy. I thought they was in a desert place. Didn't the Bible say that he went to a desert place? Okay, well, how did water get in the desert? Sound like it must be pretty important to me. If he made it where the water was in the desert.
Yes.
Say, hold on, wait a minute. There's some water over there.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, give him praise, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Y'all don't like this kind of teaching.
It's good.
All right, come on, let's come on in.
And when they were come up out of the water.
Come up out the water, so that means he had to go down in it. When he came up out of the water.
The Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip.
That's the Holy Ghost. The Spirit of the Lord caught him away. Now that's what you call. What you call it, transporting? Amen. Spirit of the Lord transporting. You know, we got some heavy stuff in the Bible.
Yes.
We just read right on by. The Spirit of the Lord caught him away. Go to verse, next verse. The Lord transported him. Pew! Come on, read.
That the eunuch saw him no more.
Uh-huh.
And he went on his way rejoicing.
And he went on his way. So when you get this thing down on the inside of you, it's not for you to be sad. Oh, man, I can't see it no more. I don't know if I did the right thing. Look at all them pretty girls over there. Come on, give God praise. You know, that's how the devil come to you. See, I told you not to do it. Now you can't get you none no more. Hallelujah. You better tell that. You better do like the Lord said, get behind me. Don't try to mess my mind up. And just about that time, you're going to come one walk. Hey, honey, hi. You got to have strength enough to say bye. Come on, give God praise. You got to have that kind of strength. Because all it's going to do is mess up your life. You got some pretty women out there. My wife don't mind me saying she knows some pretty women out there. I ain't blind. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
Nice shapes and all. I'm still a man. Come on, give God praise. But the preacher say I keep up under my body and bring it to subjection so that after I have preached unto others, I myself will not be a castaway.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give him praise. So in other words, you got to learn how to tame this body. You let it get loose, it'll be everywhere. You want this one. Ooh, look at that one. Ooh, ooh. You better tame that flesh. Come on, give God praise. Because it never, you know, lust, what's the definition of lust? An insatiable desire. A desire that never is satisfied. So ain't no sense in me trying to deal with something I can't satisfy. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
Well, let me move on. I don't want to get too graphic. Hallelujah. So, brethren, I'm way over what I'm supposed to be. Brethren, my time. Let us get a level head. Keep a level head. This kind of teaching, it's in the Bible. What I just read to you is in the Bible. But a lot of people didn't see it. They ran right by it. They didn't see that. It must be a necessity for you to do that. But people don't teach it because, oh, that sounds too religious. Okay. You're going to count out your blessing. You're going to exclude yourself. Bible talks about they that was washed in the blood was the one that inherited the promise. How do you get washed in it? I'll let you figure that out. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
You figure it out how you get washed. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
So we have come to redo what Adam did. What Adam messed up, we come to straighten it out.
Amen.
We come to be good fathers to our families. We come to be good husbands to our wives. I can't, you know, I'm getting older now. Sister Coleman get older. If she turns 60 years old, I can't be saying, baby, I'm gonna have to trade you in for 230 years old. Getting old, baby. No. She look at me and say, well, what you want me to do? You want me to trade you in? I say, no, forget that. No, we ain't gonna talk about that. We just gonna have to be for one another. Come on, give God praise. Come on. You know, cause that happens. Sometimes people get to the place, you know, they you know, you ain't looking good like you used to. Well, you ain't either. Come on, give him praise. And then life is funny. Life would sneak up on you. Have you ever noticed sometimes people that you thought was ugly back when you was young, you see them 20, 30 years later, wow, is that the same person? She bad, man. We thought she was the ugliest woman in the school. Look at her now. She bad. The Lord didn't know how to turn it around. You thought you was the pretty. I've seen some pretty, pretty women, and then later on saw them that, ooh. That's the same woman. Sin will beat you down. Come on, give God praise. So just appreciate what God bless you with. Appreciate your choice. Just because you marry a woman that's got that Coca-Cola bottle shape, looking all pretty and all good don't mean that she gonna stay like that. So you make up in your mind, I'm staying with who God blessed me to be with. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
You might start off, she 26, 36, what is it? 34, 26, 34? Oh, they done took off some numbers. It used to be 36. So 30, whatever. Start off and see all like that. 10 years later, she a bloom. She a 2 liter. You had a Coca-Cola bottle, now you got a 2 liter. Come on, give God praise. What you got to do? Stay with him. I love you anyhow, baby. I know somebody, they gritting on it. Ooh, yeah, stay with him. That's your baby. If y'all get together, y'all go walk. Come on, baby, we going walking. Do what you can. That's yours. That's it. It's a done deal. People need to get back to that. You want a divorce? Oh, I know I'm over my time, but divorce is sometimes a terrible thing. A lot of people get hurt in divorce. And most of the time, it's not a clean cut. Sometimes you tear it apart. You know, when you tear things, it ripping all kind of places. Emotional situation messed up. You know, your mind messed up because it's torn apart. Can't agree on anything. So it's better to stay together than to rip something apart. Now you got all fragments. The kids are damaged. Come on, somebody. Can I talk to y'all? Y'all might not like this kind of preaching, but this is the kind of preaching you need. You need to learn how to stay together. Families need to stay together. Brothers need to position in their mind, I'm going to be something in life. I ain't going to be no bum. That thing scared me when I was a young man. I was riding with my mama one time, and I seen a bum on the street. I got scared. What's up, mama? What happened to him? Come on, give God praise. And then with me and my brother, we go almost start laughing. Don't you all laugh. You know, back then when they told you something, you hurried up and stopped. They had a look that make you behave. You cutting up their look, you get in line. But that scared me. I say, I can't be that. Come on, give God praise. You'll be like the prodigal son that end up in the hog pen. So glad he came to himself. How many high servants have my father and bread enough to eat? And here I am perishing with hunger. I'm going to rise up from here and go to my father and say, Father, I have sinned. And I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Just make me one of your hired servants. Father said, shut up talking like that, boy. You my son. Go in there and kill the fatted calf. Bring me the best robe in the house. Put a ring on his finger. Hallelujah. That ring, that was a credit card. You just punch that ring, get whatever you want. Woo, this Bible is something else. I'm not through. I'm just going to quit. Come on, give God praise. I'm just going to stop. So sometimes you can get twisted up with everybody, all these different people saying all these different things. You know, and I don't advertise Christianity because it's been tainted so bad. But there are some things that the Christians did that you shouldn't leave off. Come on, give God praise. There's some wholesome things in it. Change my life. I got to change life. I ain't the man I used to be. Nowhere near the person I used to be. Come on, give God praise. Hallelujah. Some of y'all, I know y'all ain't the person y'all used to be. Some of y'all used to carry straight razors. Got that pistol in your pocketbook. Oh, come on, give God praise. Some of y'all was some treacherous folk. Y'all had some mouths that where Rudy Ray Moore. Rudy Ray Moore, you curse Rudy Ray Moore out. Come on, give God praise. But he changed you. You changed now. So you can't take that away from me. You can run away from me all you want, but you can't take this. I got this. And you can't take it. Come on, give God praise. This is something that you're going to need. When it heat up, you're going to need this. All right, let me stop. Close the book. Close the book. Oh, you already got it closed. It's over. But fathers, we have a grave responsibility. Raise your family. Make your, even if your children don't want to obey you, make them wish that they had them. Come on, give them praise. And don't fool yourself. You need this. I wonder if there's anybody in the house that want to get baptized today. I don't know. Maybe. This ain't for everybody. You know, so, let me say this, then I'm going to stop. Some people, they want the best of both worlds.